Okay, so I'm driving along the curl line here and I'm due to turn off somewhere a little bit close to here. Right, so I'm looking for Anadown Pier, which is basically a pier out here. Now this is what I call a Sunday drive.
Brucey.
My mind. Absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, that was good time.
Do you not see me coming right up to you?
I did, at
the T-junction.
This is Anadown Pier in Lough, Corrib. And it is an absolutely beautiful day. Look at this, I'm wearing a T-shirt. My brother Ronan, he's going fishing. This is where he keeps his boat.
Here, hiya Bruce.
That's a good dog, Bruce.
Dog absolutely loves it here. When the boats go out, they cut the engines. Just the silence here is bliss. You hear the birds, the flora and the fauna, and it's roasting.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm not an expert now, right?
It doesn't matter. Sure.
But anyhow, it says,
who is?
Just out here, he's going into Galway. You know Wood Quay?
Yeah.
The quay. So they're bringing in things to sell at the market. There you are, 1829.
1829?
September, yeah. 28 maybe, is it? Sorry, 28.
Oh, 1828. 4th of September, 1828,
yeah.
Was the day that a boat
left Anadown, or Anacoon, to go into Galway to the fair, right?
Yeah.
And I was heading down the Narrows on Lough Corrib, and apparently a sheep put his foot through the boat.
Okay, so it wasn't just here?
No,
without... You see, this is how stories...
They left from here.
This is how stories change, and I always thought they drowned just off the pier. Do you know what I mean? I always thought it happened here, just there.
Yeah, so. Well, I think it wasn't too far. I think it's just that's called an
arrow. Oh, really? Was it? Yeah. Arrows. So I have the gear back in the car now, and I'm going to get on my way and go somewhere else. Very sort of wealthy monastery, and it was pretty much ransacked or pillaged or whatever the word is by Cromwell's men. And there was a large bell in the tower, and apparently it was worth a lot of money. There was a lot of brass in it, so the monks, before Cromwell came, they dumped it in the river so that they couldn't get the wealth from it. They wouldn't let them steal it, so they literally pushed it out there and let it sink into the silty water of the river there. So that is the story of this place.
So the sun has come out again and I've decided to keep going north for another few miles, not that far, and it's going to bring me as far as a small village called Cong.
Time now to go off the beaten track here. I have no idea where I'm going. All I know that is this is, yeah.
Isn't that just spectacular? That's Ashford Castle in its full glory right there. Absolutely amazing. It's another era in time. I know it's got extensions done to the back that sort of matches in with the old building, but it's a fabulous, fabulous place. Wow. Fat bike held up well there on some of the really gnarly trails. Those places there where the mud was quite deep and those big fat tires just glided right over them. Now that is a tidy motor.
Hello to the camera.
Hello to the camera. Up and on my head.
Good man. All right, thanks a
million. Thanks so much, guys.
Sound. Cycling with no hands. So this is Cong here, and I'm standing at the statue of John Wayne, Scarlett O'Hara. Let me see. This statue is dedicated to all those involved in the 1951 production of the film The Quiet Man, which was filmed here in Cong. The statue depicts the characters of Sean Thornton, played by John Wayne, and Mary Kate Danaher, played by Maureen O'Hara. I had said Scarlett O'Hara, but it's Maureen O'Hara. Very interesting stuff. Check it out. And on that note, I'm going to end the video here. Thanks for watching, guys, from Cong. Until next time, I'll see you again.